Lane Stadium in the NFL as you get a look inside Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay, and this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Philadelphia Eagles. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Now on first down. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Give the sack to Fletcher Cox.
A lot of talk the other day about them wanting to quiet this home crowd early and often. Very first play of the game, they do just that.
You're exactly right about that, because that's often a conversation when you go on the road and you travel. Hey, let's take the crowd out of it. What a great way of doing so by putting the quarterback on the deck.
And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety. So how's that for an interesting way to start this ball game?
First drive of the game and you go backwards all the way into your own end zone?
Guess it kind of makes you wonder what else we might have in store here in this one.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 23.
And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. Kenny Clark, the big D tackle there to make the stop.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Yeah, this is going to be an Eagles first down as he's got this up to about the 34-yard line.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Throwing is Hurts.
Quick hitter here. It's complete. 3 yards the gain there. Second down.
Oh, I see you nodding your head along with me, partner, because it's pretty obvious what they were trying to do there on the drag route. With his speed, they're hoping he can turn the corner and maybe take this to the house. But that was excellent work defensively to make sure once he caught it, he wasn't going anywhere.
This a second and 7 from the 37.
He finds his man complete. It's Peterson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. And off comes to Peterson. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second and nine, Hurts. Flushed, and a big loss here as he's taken down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
I always love the opening game of the season. And for the players, always nice to get those firsts out of the way, isn't it? How about here, the first sack of the season. Not just in the first game, but in the opening drive. That's the way to get things kicked off.
Now on third and long, they'll look. It's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. Despite a pickup of 16, they're still well short of the sticks. Not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. He delivers another to Goddard. Complete. And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And a safety the last go-around. That's how we arrived at this 2-0 score. See if they can respond.
Such an oddity, isn't it? See those 2 points go up on the board knowing
like
that
soccer.
You, exactly. And knowing that you did it to give those points up for your team, now they're just looking to get back out on the field and make up for it.
Second and 12. Rodgers going deep this time for Miller. That's caught inside the 20. And he'll get this inside of Philly's 20 before being taken down. It's a big play there for Green Bay. So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
And Brandon, as you know, sometimes it's a lot tougher to run with these tight ends nowadays in the NFL. They're just bigger wide receivers. He lined up on the left side of the formation, ran a drag route across the field, and tried to work his way open. He was able to make the catch, but the defenders were there, couldn't do a whole lot with it afterwards.
Throwing again on second down, Rodgers. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Good coverage on the outside, and I think that's where he wanted to check that down to. But once he saw the danger over there, he just threw that one over everyone's head. Smart play.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Rodgers to throw once more. This one swung out here to Jones. And the Packers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Now Jones. A pickup of 4 on first down. It'll be second and goal. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. Extra bulk up front for second and inches. Three tight ends. Rodgers with a keeper. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. The sneak successful from a yard out. And the Packers have taken the lead. Extra point put through by Boswell. And the lead is up to five. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. From the 10. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. And able to break this out all the way to the 38-yard line. Great return. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They start the drive with Peterson. And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around five.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. They give it to Peterson. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles. Because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And I see an extra defensive back on the field. A little surprise here on third and one. Here's Peterson. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. The Eagles send out their punter now as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And there's a work of art right there. Out of bounds at the 2-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And they will begin with, should we call it, far from ideal starting field position, their own 2-yard line.
So what's your definition of ideal?
The 1-yard line on the other side of the field.
Yes, exactly right. So yes, your definition is apropos in this case.
And he was very fortunate there to get out of his end zone. He maybe got back to the 2-yard line. Here's Jones again on second down. And he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Rodgers going to try and throw on third down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 19. So they will set up shop. Excellent field position in the red zone at the 19-yard line. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Adrian Peterson scampering home from 19 yards out. And once again, the Eagles are back out in front. Elliott Good with a PAT. And the lead is now two. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. zone for a touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Escaping the pressure right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Rodgers. A check down here to Jones. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
So now third and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Now it's Rodgers. Going up top for Miller. And this throw will be intercepted. Picked off by the USC man, Adoree Jackson. And the Eagles are going to take over here at their own 22-yard line.
Well, I tell you, Brandon, this ball's intercepted, but it is third down. So the silver lining is that since this is so far down the field and there wasn't a big run back associated with it, really this kind of works like a punt. It's not an altogether bad result.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
On second and 9, Hurts. He finds his tight end, Goddard. That's complete. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them, or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
A big boot that time. 57 yards the official distance. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. A big play that time through the air. 33 yards.
Well, he reminded us that he was a 1,000-yard receiver a year ago as he starts off week one picking up right where he left off. He told us at the end of the preseason he was primed for a big year. He just gave us excellent evidence of his belief.
So the line of scrimmage all the way up to midfield now as they've got it first and 10. From midfield, here's Rodgers. And his pass incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Rodgers gonna throw. Looking for Campbell downfield. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And the Eagles are gonna take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Boy, Charles, that is now three interceptions in three consecutive drives, and you can see he's just got a look of disgust and bad body language, understandably, as he walks off the field.
And I think it comes from the fact that he's not sure what he sees down the field, Brandon. I don't know if he's seeing ghosts. I don't know if he just can't read defenses. I'm not sure what it is, but that's why he's frustrated. Think about the defense right now. Every time they run on the field, they've gone from hoping to intercept the pass to expecting to intercept passes. Their confidence at an all-time high right now.
Wide open receiver complete. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Play action. Here's Hurts. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
A 10th carry now for Peterson. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. A couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. He finds his man complete. It's Peterson. Touchdown, Philadelphia! For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible. Elliott good on the extra point, and that makes this a 9-point game. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they will not really have time to do much of anything. 15 seconds, all that remains before halftime. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
It's a new season, so both of these coaching staffs likely making plenty of adjustments after their first half of football. So for the call of the second half here in week one, we go back to Brandon and Charles.
right, Coach. Thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. And how about this right out of the locker room, an onside kick attempt. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators. They sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, Coach. We can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
The third quarter starts with a run by Peterson. He takes this for about six down inside the 40.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
They run again with Peterson, and he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. 72 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
They go play action with Hurts. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Peterson is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia.
Partner, they had a good lead as they went in at the half, and they came out here in the second half and found a way to extend it. I love their consistency. Don't worry about what they said at halftime. This seemed like a team that was ready to play 60 minutes, and while this game is far from over, I love their approach.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and that could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. The left side completion to Jones. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball and let him do his thing. And they got it out to him on the left side. And he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line. Throwing now is Rodgers. Going deep this time for Miller. And this is caught inside the five. And it's a Packers touchdown. Even later into his career now, there aren't too many guys that can launch it downfield with accuracy better than Aaron Rodgers.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield, and you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
Yeah, and that throw, my goodness, and even 70 yards through the air. So now Rodgers will lead the Packers up to go for two. They'll give it to the fullback up the middle. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. And he is going to be stopped short of the goal line. Oh, they'll mark him inside the one. He just couldn't keep churning those extra few inches.
And the two-point attempt is turned aside. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. This is Smith with a grab. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A big connection on that one. 32 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. From the pistol, they run with Peterson. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Here's Hurts to throw. And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Sets up to throw it. Throw right side, caught by Goddard, the tight end. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
That's another beautiful throw right there. It gets it to his man right in stride. And I think that throw kind of exemplifies what we've seen from this offense throughout this game. They've been in rhythm, they've been sharp, they've been on it. And they pick up another first down there.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
So many times we've seen him try to escape the pocket and do something with his legs, but in this case, the pressure was too intense, and he made the wise choice to just get rid of the football and make sure no one was going to get it.
On second down, Peterson. And he gets it down close to the 10-yard line. 76 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Throw left side complete. That's Peterson. Touchdown, Eagles! Adrian Peterson. An 11-yard touchdown. And the Eagles are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. Elliott good on the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Now Ross to return. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Maybe a little frustration starting to creep in. The offensive line hasn't done a great job of protecting him in this game, and there he was, hit again as he threw it.
Yeah, another time on his backside, probably starting to get a little frustrated.
Got to keep his composure. Can't let the defense know that they're getting to him.
And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him.
Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Rodgers to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 36. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
Well, this is simply a great read by a defensive back. It's third and 10, so he sits right on where the yard to gain marker is, knows it's going to be a route around that distance, makes his read, breaks on the football, and makes a terrific play.
That is caught. It's the tight end Goddard. And they move this all the way down to the 9. They'll run with Peterson. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now 2nd and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
They'll run for it with Peterson. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a 3rd down. Hurts. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And the Packers are going to have it here at their own 9-yard line. Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but, yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And, look, we're still in the 3rd quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
Rodgers now on 1st down. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's 2nd down.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn into a long gain, or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points, and the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
On play action, it's Rodgers. He finds the speedster Ross, that's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. We are through 3 quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. So the false start will back them up 5. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. 2nd down and long. To throw, it's Rodgers. Throw left side here, complete to Campbell. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And all of a sudden here, it's 3rd down. Come out.
shotgun now for Rodgers. Going up top for Miller. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A big play that time through the air. 34 yards. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
Throwing on second and 8. Rodgers, and that's incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Throw left side, taken in by Miller. And he'll be tackled right on the 10, well short of the first down. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. Now Rodgers, gotta have this one. And it's gonna be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. The Packers unable to pick up the first. And the Eagles defense able to hold. Here's Peterson as they begin on the ground. And able to find a little space. He gets this up over the 15 to the 16. 85 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. The last run got 6. Now 2nd and 4. Throwing is Hurts. He finds his tight end, Goddard. That's complete. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. But first down, Hurts. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Play action. Here's Hurts. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Turning into a really good performance on the road. Week 1, you're just hoping for that first win. It's tough to do it away from home, though, but they're looking strong.
It certainly is. Any road win in the NFL is a great road win. I mean, it just does not matter whether it's supposed to be tough or not. In this particular situation, how great will they feel leaving with a win on the road against a tough opponent?
A little work still to do, though. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And whatever promise they showed in the preseason has not translated into Week 1 because they have not been particularly competitive here. At home, no less. These fans just kind of beside themselves right now. Here's Rodgers. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
I think this one offensively, this is one where you just say, let's move on. Let's not even watch the game tapes from this one.
Yeah, you might just want to throw it in the trash, act like it was never there in the first place.
Yeah, just say we're good. I actually have heard of a coach in the past who took his team out to the practice field and ceremonially buried the game films from the prior game when they got clobbered. That was his way of putting it behind them.
And that is incomplete. But the pressure there on third down, forcing the errant pass. Fourth down coming up.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. Looking left side. He's got it. Complete. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Elliott on for the extra point. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. The Packers on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a fourth down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. Rodgers gonna go on fourth down. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. And again, it's Rodgers. This one swung out here to Jones. It'll be a gain of 5. And it's a second down. To throw is Rodgers. That ball caught by Campbell. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 30. Now Rodgers. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. To throw again on second down. Rodgers. And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one to the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big.
Now, this opening game has certainly not gone their way to this point, but, you know, that touchdown, maybe a glimmer of hope for the long season ahead.
And no one in this league likes to talk about moral victories. No one likes to really just say, okay, well, maybe something went right. But you're exactly right about that. A little glimmer there, maybe they can carry it over moving forward.
Boswell for the extra point. and the lead is down to 24. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Short kick. One of the up middle take it down. And it'll end there as he goes out of bounds, but a heck of a return all the way inside the opposite 40. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Eagles, hey, you get a win, you get it on the road. You can't ask for much more than that to start the year. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the Seattle Seahawks. Meanwhile, for the Packers...